Well, in this session, we'll learn about different types of flow control like if, elif, for, while, etc. that we are going to use in Python. Next is the Python flow control. Well, these flow controls are the one which control the flow of execution of your program. So we have six different types of flow control in Python: if else, nested if else, for, while, break, and continue. Let's discuss them one by one, starting with if else. So what is this if else? Let's see its syntax. If the condition is true, then execute statement 1, else execute statement 2. It's as simple as that. Let's see the flow of execution. You start it, you check the condition. If the condition is true, then execute block 1. If the condition is false, then go to the else part and execute block 2. Fine? Yeah, this block 1, it comes under if part. Alright? Let's move next. Let's move ahead. Next is nested if else. Let's see the syntax. If condition 1 is true, then execute statement 1. Else, if condition 2 is true, then execute statement true. If none of them is true, then execute statement 3. Let's check the flow control of it. Start, check for condition 1. That is, if condition 1 is true. So if condition 1 is true, then the statement executed with the if block is executed. That is, execute block 1. If first condition is false, then go and check for the second condition, that is else if condition. Now if else if condition is true, then your second block would be executed. If none of them are true, then finally the else block would be executed. That is execute block 3. And yeah, remember one thing, there is no condition associated with a else block. Else block would only execute if all the if conditions are false. Fine? Alright. Next is the for. Let's see the syntax. For iterating variable in sequence, colon execute statement. Let's check. Well, it's the example of a program. Like start, we are defining a variable as count equals 0. Then execute statement. Then increment the value of count by 1. And then check the condition if count is less than 10. Is 1 less than 10? Yeah, the condition is true. So again repeat it and again execute the statement. Again increment the value of count by 1, that is count become 2. And again check if 2 is less than 3. And so on, continue this till 10 is less than 10. And when this thing arrives that 10 is less than 10, your condition become false and you exit the loop. So this is how a for loop works. Let's understand this in a better way with an example. So this is our code. Alright. We have defined a list fruits as apple, banana and cherry. For x in fruits, x in fruit of 0 is apple. Then print x, x is what? Apple. So apple would be printed as the output. Now again, what we'll do? We'll again go back and check for x in fruits. Now x of 1 is banana. Then print x, x is what? Banana. So it would print as banana. Again, it will go back, x in fruit of 2 is what? Cherry. Print x, cherry would be printed. Now if it goes back, there's nothing left in the fruit. So nothing would be printed, alright? So you got the final output as apple, banana and cherry. Fine? Alright. So let's move ahead. Next is the while. The syntax for this is, while condition is true, then execute set of statement under the while. Start, check for the condition. If it is true, then execute block 1 and then again repeat the loop until the condition is true. In case the condition is false, then just exit the loop. Let's understand this better with an example. This is my code. Like a equal 1. In variable part, I got a equal 1. While a is less than 5. Is a equal 1 less than 5? Yeah, condition is true. Then what? Print the value of a. Alright, so we got the output as 1. After getting the output, increase the value of a by 2. So a plus equal to 2. That is 1 plus 2 equal 3. Now again, go back to the loop. Check for the condition. Is 3 less than 5? Condition is true. Then again, go to the print A part. What is A? 3. So print A. So you will get the output as 3. Again, increment the value of A to 2. That is A equal 5. Now check the condition. Is 5 less than 5? No. I think here we got the condition as false. So we got the final output as 1 and 3. Alright. Let's move ahead. Here's another example. A equal 1. In the variable part A equal 1. Check the condition. While A is less than 3. Is 1 less than 3? Yeah, condition is true. Inside the while part, the first condition that we check. If A mod 2 equal 0. Is 1 mod 2 equal 0? No, the condition is false. So we'll jump to the else part. So we'll jump to the else part and print A is odd. Now since the value of A currently is 1, so 1 is odd. Fine. Then what we'll do, we'll increment the value of A by 1. That is 1 plus 1 equal 2. Fine. Now again we'll go back to the while part. Now we'll check if 2 is less than 3. Yeah, the condition is true. Fine. Now what we'll do, we'll jump to the if part. And check if 2 mod 2 equal 0. Yeah, the condition is true. So this time we'll check if 2 mod 2 equal 0. So yeah, the condition is true. So what it will do, it will print the if part statement. That is, A is even. A in this case was 2. So 2 is even. Fine. So this is our output. Next, again, it will go and increment the value of A by 1. So now 2 becomes 3. Again, it will go back to the while part. Is 3 less than 3? The condition is false. So your final output is 1 is odd and 2 is even. Fine. So this was about the while statement. Let's move ahead and learn about break. So this break statement, it is used to break the loop at a certain condition. Alright. Let's understand this with the help of this flowchart. Start it, check the condition. If the condition is true, then check the break. Then check the break condition. If the break condition is false, then only execute block 1 and repeat the loop. If the break condition comes to be true, then break the entire loop and then exit the loop. Alright. Let's check it with an example up here. For example, A equal 10. While A is greater than 0. Check for if A is not equal to 5. If A is not equal to 5, then print A. Else, break it. Fine. Let's execute it. Sorry. This bench. A. Minus minus. A minus equal to 1. Fine.
stop it. Let's mention it up here.
So we got the output as 9, 8, 7, and 6. Fine. So the moment loop becomes 5, we got exited out of the loop. Next we have is the continue statement. Well, the continue statement won't break the loop. So it will just skip the statement in case the condition is true. Let's understand this with the help of this flowchart. So start, check for condition 1. If it is true, then check for continue condition. If it is false, then execute block and repeat. Then in case if the condition is true, then stop executing that particular block for that particular loop and cut for that particular iteration, and again go back and repeat and check the condition. So this was all for this session. In case you have any doubt, so you can reach out to Intellipaat 24/7 and we'll try to resolve your query ASAP. Thank you.